I, Poonam Tank, working as a nursing tutor in TNDV Institute of Nursing. Today I am going to demonstrate a procedure of oxygen therapy. Introduction. Oxygen is a colorless, odorless, tasteless gas that is essential for the body to function properly and to survive. Oxygen therapy is an administration of oxygen at a concentration of pressure greater than that found in the environmental atmosphere. The air that we breathe contains approximately 21% oxygen. Oxygen therapy is a key treatment in respiratory care. Purpose of oxygen therapy: to relieve dyspnea, to administer low concentration and high concentration of oxygen to patient, to allow uninterrupted supply of oxygen during activities, relieve hypoxemia and hypoxia, to alleviate associated with struggle to breathe. Indication of oxygen therapy: breathlessness and labored breathing, high altitude, shock and circulatory failure, anemia, patient under anesthesia, critically ill patient, decreased respiratory capacity, provide an environment for the patient with controlled oxygen concentration and temperature regulation and humidity control. It allows freedom of movement in bed. Contraindication of oxygen therapy: atelectasis, oxygen toxicity. It creates a feeling of isolation. It requires high level of oxygen. There is an increased chance of hazard due to fire. It requires much time and effort to cleaning and maintenance. General instruction in oxygen therapy: oxygen treated as a drug. Every part of apparatus should be clean to prevent infection. Change nasal catheter every 8 hourly to prevent the blockage of nasal catheter. When oxygen therapy is to be discontinued, it should be done gradually. Watch the patient receiving oxygen therapy continuously to detect the early sign of oxygen toxicity. Preparation of the patient in oxygen therapy: check name, bed number and other identification marks of the patient. Check the diagnosis and the need of oxygen therapy. Check doctor's order for initiation of therapy and dosage. Assess the patient for any sign of clinical anoxia. Assess patient vital sign and breathing pattern carefully before starting therapy. Gain the patient confidence. Keep the patient in propped up position or Fowler's position. Tray used for oxygen therapy. This tray contains oxygen mask with tubing, nasal cannula and oxygen hood to deliver oxygen. Measuring cup with sterile water to fill humidifier. Swab stick to clean nostrils. Clean gloves to prevent infection. Adhesive tape to attach nasal cannula. Spirit swab to clean mask. Gauze paste to prevent skin in irritation near to ear. Paper bag and kidney tray to discard the waste. Nursing record sheet to record the data. Oxygen cylinder with stand. Humidifier with flow meter and regulator to deliver oxygen. Definition of cannula method: a method by which oxygen is administered in low concentration through a cannula, which is a disposable plastic device with two protruding prongs for insertion into the nostrils. Procedure of cannula method: determine need of oxygen therapy in patient, check physician order for RET device, use and concentration and perform as a assessment of vital sign, level of consciousness, lab value and mark report. Step 2. Set up oxygen equipments. Step 3. Fill humidifier up to the level marked on it with sterile water. Step 4. Attach flow meter to source and set flow meter in off position. Step 5. Attach humidifier to base of flow meter and attach tubing and nasal cannula to humidifier. Step 6. Regulate flow meter to prescribed level and ensure proper functioning by checking for bubbles in humidifier or filling oxygen at the outlets. And place tip of cannula to patient's ear and adjust straps around ear for snack fit. The elastic band may fit behind the head or under chin, and keep pad tubing with gauze pad over. Oxygen administration by nasal catheter method. Nasal catheters are used less frequently these days. It involves inserting an oxygen catheter and simple rubber catheter into the nasopharynx. It needs to be changed at least every 8 hours and inserted into the other nostrils. It also painful and can cause trauma. Thus, this is less desirable. Definition of mask method. Administering oxygen to the patient by means of mask in that simple or venturi mask according to the requirement of patient. Step 1. In mask method, perform hand hygiene and put on gloves if available. Explain the procedure and the need of oxygen to the client. Step 2. In mask method, attach the humidifier to the threaded outlet of the flow meter or regulator and connect the tubing from the simple mask to the humidifier. Set the oxygen at the prescribed flow rate to apply the mask and guide the elastic straps over the top of the client head and pull the strap extension to center the mask on the client face with a different types of mask. In that, first is a partial rebreather mask, second non-rebreather mask. 3. Venturi mask. Definition of hood method. Oxygen hood is a clear plastic compartment that fit around the neonate's head and provide warm and humidified oxygen to the infant. Procedure step 1. Evaluate patient medical record and prepare patient and wash hands. Step 2. Assemble the humidifier and fill the chamber with sterile water and connect the oxygen tubing to water-filled chamber and also connect the heater tubing. Step 3. Put temperature probe on neonate chest and connect O2 tubing to hood for proper concentration to deliver the desired O2. Be sure to deliver minimum flow rate of O2 is 8 to 10 liter per minute. Step 4. Carefully place the oxygen hood over the infant head so that is loosely sealed around their neck and maintain thermal environment. Special precaution in oxygen therapy. Never deliver more than 2 to 3 liter of oxygen to patient with chronic lung disease, example COPD. Check frequency that both prongs are in a patient nose. Oxygen can be administered to baby by using oxygen hood. Oxygen hood is a plastic device. It kept over the head of the infant. It permits easy access to the child without loss of oxygen. It helps in efficient delivery of oxygen. While placing hood over the head of the child, the edge of the hood should not rub against the child's chin, neck, and shoulder. Care of oxygen cylinder. Always use the cylinder with metal case to prevent the danger of falling and breaking. Oxygen cylinder should be placed at the head end of the bed, away from the traffic areas where these are likely to be knocked. Any source of the fire should be kept away from the cylinder for fear of fire. O2 cylinder should be stored in a cool temperature away from the heaters.